The complete AV canal defect consists of a large ventricular septal defect, VSD, beneath the plane of the AV valves, an atrial septal defect, ASD, immediately superior to the plane of the AV valves. And instead of two AV valve orifices, a single or common AV valve and orifice. AV canal defects account for 4% of all congenital cardiac malformations, and over half of the cardiac defects seen in children with Down syndrome. In almost every form, the common atrioventricular valve is composed of 5 leaflets, of which only the superior and inferior bridging leaflets are found within both the left and right ventricles. Whereas the left mural leaflet is confined to the left ventricle, and the right inferior mural and right anterosuperior leaflets are located inferiorly and anterosuperiorly, respectively, in the right ventricle. The zone of apposition of the inferior and superior bridging leaflets is the most frequent site. This common valve will have a single common orifice, or will be divided into two orifices by a tongue of valve tissue. Joining the bridging leaflets, this provides the basis for a broad classification of all cases. Due to the varying degrees of incomplete development of the septal tissue surrounding the AV valve plus, along with varying degrees of abnormalities of the AV valves themselves, broad classification, partial AV canal defects, intermediate transitional defects, complete AV canal defects. The principles of operative management of AV canal defect include A. Closure of the atrial septal defect, B. Closure of the ventricular septal defect, C. Creation of two non-stenotic competent AV valves, and D. Avoidance of damage to the AV node and bundle of His. Repair of complete AV canal defects has been described using single patch, two patch, and modified single patch techniques. Timeline of events. 1955, Lillehei C. Walton Lillehei and colleagues. First successful repair of a complete AV canal defect. 1958, Lev described the location of the bundle of His in patients with complete AV canal defects. 1962, Maloney and colleagues plus Gerbaud. Independently described a single patch technique. 1966, Rastelli and colleagues described a classification system of complete AV canal. 1975, Georgia Trussler, two-patch technique. Rastelli and colleagues at the Mayo Clinic described a classification system of complete AV canal in 1966 that emphasized the heterogeneity of this lesion and the different approaches required by different anatomic findings. As per then, the complete AV canal defects are of three types, type A, B, and C, which serve only to highlight the variable degree of such bridging by the left superior leaflet, LSL, in a continuous spectrum of leaflet, and caudal anatomy. Deficiencies in the AV septum in patients with AV canal defects commonly result in displacement of the AV conduction tissue. The AV node usually is more posterior and inferior, near the coronary sinus ostium, than normal. The bundle of His usually courses along the inferior rim of the VSD, and therefore the bundle branches arise more inferiorly. It is this displacement of the AV node that causes the northwest axis on electrocardiogram. Key to successful repair of AV canal defects, a careful inspection of the intracardiac anatomy. B. Assessment of the right and left ventricular size. C. The size and shape of the ASD and VSD components. D. The number and location of papillary muscles. E. Arrangement of the caudal structures, including their attachment to the ventricular septum. Continuous cardiopulmonary bypass, moderate hypothermia, 28 degrees Celsius. Intermittent cold blood cardioplegia for myocardial protection. Principles of repair procedure. 1. The ventricular chambers should be gently filled with cold saline before the procedure to float the AV valve leaflets to their closed position. 2. Floating the valve leaflets with saline helps to identify the line of apposition between the anterior and posterior common leaflets. 3. Careful inspection of the leaflet tissues identifies the line that divides the valves into the right and left components. Single patch technique 1. A pericardial polytetrafluoroethylene PTFE or Dacron patch can be used in the single patch technique. A untreated pericardial patch risk of aneurysm development at the ventricular level. Bedicron patch post-operative hemolysis should a jet of mitral or tricuspid valve insufficiency strike the Dacron. Patch dimensions are size and shape of the VSDB distance between the anterior and posterior margins of the AV valve annulus. See dimensions of the atrial septal defect. Traditional single patch technique operative steps. 1. The exact apposition of the superior and inferior common leaflets is determined by floating the leaflets with ice-cold cardioplegia solution. A single 6/0 proline suture is placed through these leaflets over the crest of the ventricular septum to maintain accurate coaptation of the leaflets during incision of the superior and inferior common leaflets. 2. The superior and inferior common leaflets are incised a little to the right of the middle of the crest of the ventricular septum. An autologous pericardial patch is sutured to the middle of the ventricular septum using continuous 5/0 proline reinforced with pledgeted sutures if necessary. The bundle of His enters the ventricular septum close to the AV node and is vulnerable, particularly at the inferior end of the ventricular septal suture line. At this point, the suture line should be kept to the right of midline. 5/6 The superior and inferior common leaflets are resuspended on the pericardial patch using a continuous horizontal mattress 6/0 proline suture. In addition, pledgeted sutures are placed with the pledgets lying on the mitral side. 7. Following resuspension of the superior and inferior common leaflets, the cleft of the new mitral valve is closed as for the cleft associated with a primum ASD. The primum ASD component of the complete AV canal is closed, as for closure of an isolated primum ASD, placing the coronary sinus on the left atrial side of the patch. 2. Patch technique, first described by Trussler, uses a patch of Dacron or PTFE to close the VSD. The distance between the superior aspect of what will become the mitral valve and the crest of the ventricular septum, extent of the VSD, is assessed to accurately fashion a PTFE patch for the VSD component. The cleft in the mitral valve created between the left superior and left inferior leaflets is closed with simple interrupted polypropylene sutures. This closure is carried to the insertion site of the first order chordae tendineae at the edge of the mitral valve leaflet. Often, a small residual jet can be eliminated by further closing the cleft or placing plication sutures at the commissure. The tricuspid valve is repaired in similar fashion to the left-sided AV valve by closing the cleft between the right superior and inferior leaflets and approximating the valve edge to the atrial septal defect patch. Advantages of the two-patch technique: A. The VSD patch is composed of Dacron or PTFE. This material does not dilate over time and avoids the risk of aneurysm formation, which has been reported after using pericardium for closure of the VSD component of the AV canal defect. Modified single patch technique, a simplified method for the repair of complete atrioventricular canal CAVC, was reported by Wilcox in 1997, Nunn in 1999, and Nicholson et al. In 1999, whereby the ventricular septal defect VSD is closed without utilizing a patch, by directly suturing the atrioventricular valve AVV leaflets onto the crest of the VSD. This concept had long been applied to some extent by surgeons when faced with small VSD components, especially under the inferior bridging leaflet. Hence, the modified single patch technique looked appealing and gained popularity, making its way into our surgical armamentarium as an alternative technique for the treatment of CAVC. Described by Graham Nunn, has reported 72 consecutive repairs using this technique beginning in 1995. 1. The Australian technique for repair of complete AV canal involves placement of multiple interrupted pledgeted sutures on the right side of the crest of the ventricular septum. These sutures are passed through the superior and inferior common leaflets and then through an autologous pericardial patch. 2. Tying the sutures placed in the ventricular crest as part of the Australian technique obliterates the VSD by bringing the common AV valve leaflets down to the crest of the septum. Partial AV canal repair. The ostium primum atrial septal defect is a crescent-shaped defect in the inferior portion of the atrial septum immediately adjacent to the AV valve. Operative steps. One. A primum atrial septal defect is usually associated with a cleft of the anterior leaflet of the mitral valve. 2. Cleft closure should be performed by meticulously accurate apposition of the cleft edges. This is usually best achieved by simple 6/0 or 7/0 proline sutures. If there is central incompetence following cleft closure, An annuloplasty can be performed by tightening one or both commissures with doubly pledgeted horizontal mattress sutures. Transitional AV canal repair operative steps. 1. The transitional AV canal most commonly includes an interventricular communication at the level of the cleft. 2. Closure of the primum ASD component of all forms of AV canal should place the coronary sinus and AV node on the left atrial side of the autologous pericardial pad. Rest of the ventricular septum lies immediately underneath the AV valve's leaflets, as indicated. There may be restrictive ventricular communications in this region necessitating application of the Australian technique as used for complete AV canal. If the only ventricular communication in a transitional AV canal is at the level of the cleft, the defect can be closed with a single pledgeted horizontal mattress suture. The remainder of the repair is as for primum ASD closure, placing the coronary sinus on the left atrial side of the patch. Special situations with AV canal defect repair. 1. AV canal with tetralogy of Fallot, use a two-patch technique. Patch needs to be wider near the subaortic area to allow enough redundancy at the anterosuperior end of the VSD and thus avoid left ventricular outflow tract obstruction. VSD patch is comma-shaped with the two-patch technique. The presence of tetralogy of Fallot imposes some modifications in the technique used for AV canal repair. The most common conotruncal anomaly associated with AV canal defect is tetralogy of Fallot. It is encountered in approximately 6% of cases of AV canal. Results. The results of the various techniques can be best evaluated by examining the A. operative mortality, B. re-operation rates for mitral insufficiency, C. pacemaker, D. left ventricular outflow tract obstruction, E. residual ASD or VSD. Notes. A. If either the mitral or tricuspid portion is smaller than normal, this copting suture is moved to a more appropriate site. B. An orifice 1 standard deviation smaller than the mean normal mitral valve is acceptable. Thank you.